Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome today to our remembrance service for Elizabeth George Coutts. My name is Greg Illingworth. 15 years ago, I had the privilege of officiating a Jack's ceremony of remembrance. It's a long time ago, isn't it? And we fondly remember Jack today as well. But as we come together today to remember Betty, this is a very important day that we gather. These are difficult days. It's never easy to come along to services like this. But yet it's so important just to come and remember her and all those memories and all those times you spent. It's good to recollect those things as we gather this afternoon. There will be a private cremation service happening following our service here today. As we gather, we will be hearing from a couple of different people today amongst you as family, and I'll also be sharing on behalf of some others. But can I firstly extend my sympathy to all of you, especially to you, Ron, and to John and to Sandra as well, and all of you as family. And we recognise too, don't we, that today there's only a small number of us here. There's only 20 of us gathered here today. And there are many more that would love to have been here, but due to our current restrictions, we're not able to do that. So we think of all those that are here, remembering very fondly today Betty's memory. So how do we possibly sum up somebody's life in just the few minutes we're going to spend together? It's impossible, isn't it, to do that. But today we will just be highlighting some things about Betty's life and remembering her together. Betty McRae was born on the 31st of March 1937 in Aberdeen in Scotland, and she passed away on the 20th of May. She was one of six children born to Robert and Mary McRae. And she is survived today by her two sisters in Nora and Jean, and also by her children today in Ronald and John with his wife Sandra, also by five grandchildren and two great-grandchildren. So firstly, as we begin to share some memories, I'm going to be sharing on behalf, as I mentioned earlier, of some of you as family today, and firstly, mainly from grandchildren, and firstly from Adele. I have this from Adele. She says this. Do you want to come up, Adele? Lovely. Come on up. Please do.
Nana, you were the best Nana a granddaughter could have ever asked for. I'm so grateful I got to create so many memories with you, whether it be a shot at my birthday, a drink at a party, a visit to your house to listen to all your stories, or a family holiday. There were so many beautiful memories that I will cherish forever. You were always there for everything and anything, so things definitely won't be the same without you around, but I know you're back with your one true love looking over all of us. I will forever miss you and always love you. Fly high, my darling Nana.
Thanks, Adele. We really appreciate you doing that today, and beautiful thoughts that you've got together about your Nana today. Ron, I'm wondering if you might like to come forward now and share with us, please. Thank you.
Give me a second to get ready. There we go. Hey, Ma. Well, we're all here to say our final goodbyes. I've got to say, it's not easy. Everyone here knows you. They know how much you loved life, loved to sing, loved to dance, loved a good party, and loved a good laugh. And we all remember how much you loved to talk. If talking was a sport, you would have been a champion. We also remember how much you loved your family. Especially your two boys. John and I are standing up here together now to tell you just how much we both loved you. Your boys could do no wrong, even when we did. Your wee 5 foot frame would stand up to 6 foot five and exclaim loudly, "No, my boys." lioness defending her cubs even after we were grown men. And Lord knows even after, Lord knows we were both daft enough even as grown men to need your help on occasion. And you were always there. But you're not here with us anymore, so we're going to have to get along without you. I think though that you and Pop taught us well. You taught us the importance of family. You taught us the importance of honesty. You taught us the importance of things like, if you can't say something nice, don't say anything at all. And those lessons were well learned, and you know, because you've seen it in your grandchildren. So those values will carry on. There is so much more to say, but we were fortunate enough to see you before you went to rest and say the things we wanted to say while you were still with us. You will be missed, Ma. And you will be remembered with love and laughter. We will remember the lesson that you did it your way. Something we will always cherish about you, even when it drove us nuts. Rest in peace, Ma. Pop's got a brandy waiting, and we're all going home soon to join you in a drink and tell stories about how fast your wee leggies could move to get a bargain. Goodbye, Ma, from your two boys. Two boys that discovered in Hawaii that they had two idiot brothers. Here's to us, guys like us. Damn few.
They're not deep.
Thank you for coming.
Oh. Right up.
Wow. Thanks, Ron. Thanks, John. Really appreciate that coming straight from the heart. It's just beautiful. I wish I could speak in that accent. It'd be so much better. It's a beautiful accent. But thank you so much for sharing today. I do have some other memories to share. If anyone else would like to come up and share their own, please signal and you're welcome to come up and do that. I have Lockie. I'm going to share on behalf of Lockie now. And Lockie penned these words in memory of his Nana today. He says this, "My Nana. What can be said about her that she probably hasn't already told you herself?" As the youngest grandchild and living in Queensland means that I've probably known her the least, but I never felt that I knew her any less. Maybe she felt it too and did things to make up for it, allowing us to have our own special relationship. Or maybe she just loved to talk. I can remember many times when I would get up to go to bed and 3 hours later still be sitting at her kitchen bench just talking. I think that is what I'll miss the most, her stories. I remember her telling him about on her wedding day she and Granddad had fish and chips. Well, at their first house didn't have electricity until a friend of theirs did the dodgy and hooked it. And it worked as long as they didn't plug too many things in at once. She was born Elizabeth George McRae, later known as Elizabeth George Coutts, Betty, Queen Elizabeth, Mum, Ma, and Nana. She was many things to many people, but to me she always was and always will be Nana. From Lockie. Thanks, Lockie. I've got something here also now from John, another one of the grandsons. Thanks, John. Appreciate you sending this through as well. John says this, "Nana, I honestly thought we would have more time together. It's hard to think that you aren't just a call or a drive away. Life as we knew it will never be the same. We shared a special bond that could never be broken. I will always be your wee man, and I will miss hearing you say, 'Not my boy,' or 'I have a 2-minute job for you.' We both knew it was never a two-minute job, but I didn't care. I'd do anything for you, Nana. You are my best friend, and I always knew that you would be there for me, whether it was listening or providing me with advice. I will miss your sharp wit, infectious smile, and positive nature. Once your mind was set, no one could change it, and I get that from you. I'll be forever grateful for the lessons I learned from you and Grandad. I'll make sure that I share them with Hayley. It breaks my heart that you won't be there to see her grow up, but I know that she has two guardian angels watching over her. Jess and I will miss the times we shared together with you that sometimes went all night and we would need a talking stick to get a word in. You are such a shining bright light in my life, Nana, and the only comfort I have without you here is knowing you are with Grandad once again. Until we meet again, love always, your wee man. Thanks, John. And this is from Sandra, as a daughter-in-law, sharing today. I think daughter, you pretty much say, by the sounds of things. To the woman I admire the most in the world, you were my holiday buddy. We travelled the world, seen a lot. You got me into mischief, but we survived. You were my shopping buddy, but made us both spend too much. You were my party buddy, but we drank too much. You were my best friend, and I don't know what to do now. You were the best mum, and you and Pop always said I was the daughter you never had. You treated me from the start as family and right to the end. I already have an empty hole that can never be replaced, but knowing you are now at peace is a tiny spot in my heart. Love you to the moon and back, Sandra. Beautiful words. Thanks, Sandra. And finally, I have one here from another granddaughter in Indiana who shares this. Nana. Nana, you were definitely one of a kind. You were the coolest Nana going around. From having a dance at any occasion, to loving a drink at any excuse, and even a sneaky shot here and there. We could always count on you for a good time. I feel so lucky to have had you as my Nana, and even luckier that my beautiful boy was blessed with almost 2 years with you. You have taught me so much through the years, from being strong, independent, and ladylike, to always having everything in moderation. And even in your last few days, you were still teaching me about how you should never do your nails on a Sunday. I will forever miss you, Nana, and the endless love and support you gave to me and Jaxie boy. Love you, Nana, and enjoy being reunited with your one true love. Love from Deanna. It's lovely. Thanks, Deanna. There are one more, is there? Yep, sure. Yeah, please, come on up. Yeah.
Dear Nana, when we last spoke, I am grateful that you told me this is goodbye. Although I wasn't ready to hear those words, I understand your choice, and I want to thank you for giving me the opportunity to say I love you one last time. You didn't let much faze you, and you always looked for the silver lining in any situation. Even at the end, you told me, I'm ready, I've had a good life. And that's undoubtedly true. You honestly lived life to the fullest, and you had a social calendar that would rival most 20-year-olds. I love how you got your first tattoo in your 70s, not 17, and how you weren't afraid to go quad biking or whitewater rafting. You always put family first, and I loved our catch-ups. I looked forward to having you talk my ear off and hear your funny antics. You somehow even made stories of your visits to the supermarket amusing, and I looked forward to hearing about it. I loved hearing about all of your travel plans and how you were always coming back from somewhere or on your way to someplace else. You were the life of any party, and you'll be pleased to know that events without you will never be the same.
I'm so grateful that you got to meet your great-grandchildren, and I know it gave you great joy to become a great-grandmother. But to me, you were already a truly great Nana. I have so many happy memories of you. Sam, Sally, and I will miss you so, so much. Thank you for being my Nana. I love you.
We're going to be enjoying looking at some photos together in just a moment, but isn't it lovely to hear those stories, those recollections that have come straight from the heart today? And it's just lovely to hear the words and the words of affirmation. And obviously a lady who was much loved and very much missed. We really appreciate those words today. Let's enjoy a photo presentation together now. Thank you.
And now the end is near, and so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every highway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do, saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, had my fill, my share of losing, and now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing to think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, oh no, not me. I did it my way. For what is a man? What has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say. Words of one who kneels.
Yes, it was my way.
If I should stay, I would only be in your way. So I'll go, but I know I'll think of you every step of the way. And I will always love you. Bittersweet memories, that is all I'm taking with me. So goodbye, please don't cry. We both know I'm not what you need. All you dreamed of, and I wish you joy and happiness. But above all this, I wish you love.
Beautifully put together, wasn't it? Some great memories there. Thank you for collecting all those photos together and presenting them that way. Can I invite us all at this point, please, to stand? If you're able to stand, will you stand with me? As we come to the closing words we'll be saying together today, I know that Betty was not one to have people like myself, celebrants, or anyone to say words about her that didn't actively know her in her life, but in spending some time with the family a couple of days ago, just two things that really stood out to me from you that said this: Betty loved life. And number two is a family were always number one, always came first. And it's Betty's death in a number of ways that unites us all and demands that at least for a time we put aside our toil, our cares, our business, our pleasures, and we join together in love today, even as we mourn and have a common bond of love and respect for Betty. And so today it is tenderly and reverently that we commit the body of Elizabeth George Coutts. We are glad for her life and for all that her life has meant to us. We are glad that she lived. We are glad that we saw her face and felt the pressure of her hand. We cherish the memory of her words and deeds and character. We cherish her friendship, and most importantly today, we cherish her love. And the final parting is signified by death is bound to bring sorrow wherever the ties of love and friendship are involved. And those of us who feel deeply will grieve deeply. And there's no philosophy or religion ever taught that can prevent this holy, natural reaction of the human heart. And yet whatever relationships that death breaks in upon, we can be sure that the memories of those and the past with all its meaning are safe and secure. What has been forever. And your love today as her family and the many friends that she had cannot be altered by time or by circumstance. So let us now resolve that while we will live, we will strive to make our living real, worthy to carry on the good things that she believed in, so that the world might be a better place because Betty Coutts walked along life's road. Thank you.